You listen to the SWN podcast.
And this is SWN.
Welcome to SWN.
Skull! Skull! Skull!
This is SWN.
And this is the Scottish Wrestling Network.
Where Scottish wrestling lives, I guess. Is that a tagline? I guess. I don't know.
Hello and welcome to the latest edition of the SWN podcast. I'm your host, as always, Billy. This is a very quick turnaround episode. It's been recorded on Thursday. You're listening to it on Friday, and I am joined by the champ. The champ is here. Last time he was on the show, it was savagely called the Windless Soldier, and since then, he's become the Iron Girders Pro Wrestling Champion. Welcome to the show, Martin MacAlistair.
Thanks so much for having me back on for the third time. I must admit that Windless Soldier really did hurt, so that might have been a big impetus for getting all this, who knows.
I know, when I suggested it, I could see you laughed on the episode, but I could see the hurt in your eyes.
Yeah, it was one of those, it was that I laughed and then I kept thinking about it lying in bed at night.
Oh man, well at least this time when I thought of a title for the episode and then contacted you, it was a little bit nicer. It was, yeah. Of course, a tribute to the boss, like it's an old tune, the fact, skit. But it's a tribute to the man, the myth, the legend, John Cena himself, with the champ is here, because you're the Iron Girders Pro Wrestling Champion.
Yeah, how did that happen? I thought it might have come up in conversation, so I did, you know, I brought it with me.
Oh, this season is great. This season so far, I think I've had like 3 belts appear on this season, and it's the best thing. That's a beautiful belt as well.
It's fantastic belt, really. It's, I'm very fond of the Glasgow kind of crest thing. That's really cool.
Very nice.
Fishing the tune on that. Let me just put that back.
Just put the £10 of gold onto the on down.
A wee podium over there for it. There was a big weekend of Iron Girder shows a few weeks back, and there was an open challenge for the belt, and I was fortunate enough to get to answer that open challenge, and I won. After a lot of shenanigans, but I did win, and I was Iron Girders champion. Got to defend it as well the next day against Shemini. So not only have I won one match, I've now won 2 matches.
Absolutely incredible. When I saw the results come in for the show, and I was like, oh my god, like oh my god.
And it's again, back, like, are you sure?
Is this correct? And then then myself also went back to the November December time when I put that tagline up and thought, oh thank god, because I started to feel guilty about it, and I was like, thank god he has got rid of that. And I was gonna give you a shout as soon as you won, pretty much, but I thought no, you're very close to the chat tsunami guys, I know they'd want to jump in first. Like I've got enough of my plate at the moment. I will hang fire and just let you digest becoming IGPW champion, which is becoming easier and easier to say as the weeks go on. We do have a question about from Westy. Asked this one because that means I can leave 5 questions for the champ at the end, because I was 6 sitting ready to go, and we could just plant all the John Cena-isms into this one. Westy has asked, how did it feel to win the Iron Girders IGPW title and finally defeat the streak?
It was truly, truly fantastic. It's been something, obviously, that's been going over me for so many years, 3 years now, so it's been a big weight off my shoulders, but I've kind of replaced it with a different big weight. But no, it's been really incredible.
What happened there?
I have no idea. I heard your audio and then your face stopped moving.
Yeah, well, your face stopped moving and then it crashed out. So, mine crashed out. So, wonderful. I'm blaming KOE for this. Your face and Adam at the weekend.
Sabotage.
So, I think we got the majority of the answer, but I think we got half the answer, which was getting the weight off your shoulders, and then adding a new weight there, and then everything died at my end. So I will check the edit tomorrow later and see how it went. But yeah, so the weight was gone. New weight of champion challenge, etc.
Yeah, so you know, obviously it was there was a big outpouring of love as well, which is very nice. You know, a lot of people come to support the big win, so that was very nice, very kind of them, and a lot of people are very excited for what the future holds. So all in all, it was really an amazing experience. But a lot of people were thinking it might have been a fluke. You know, a lot of that kind of weight now. So I did get my first win against Shamey the day after. Again, a lot of support, a lot of hype for that. But now I've just got to keep proving. And yeah, it's a big weight now because that's a heavy belt, 10 pounds of gold. Mm-hmm. And yeah, that's, I think that answers the question. Very excited. Lot to do.
That's it. And I was seeing all that outpouring of support because it was even before when you had the losing streak, whenever anyone was speaking about Martin MacAlistair, there was always such positivity, someone who'd always exuded that. And despite having so many losses in the win-loss column, you're always very positive and always looking at the next one as the next opportunity. And it was just really great to see, seeing even the likes of maybe characters that have mocked you in the past, like the Casino Brutale boys, even there, they were buzzing and all that kind of stuff. And did it really just kind of cement to you about how family oriented Iron Girders is, especially that they just all look out for their own?
Yeah, it did really cement that, you know, everyone, a lot of the guys came out to the ring, we all got to celebrate together. Some of the fans, you know, the regulars, some of them started crying, which was, they started making me cry. I'm very, very open to it that I cry a lot. So as soon as I saw someone else starting to go, that was me. So yeah, and then also just like the wider Scottish wrestling community, and I have so many messages from some of the other wrestlers up and down the country reaching out to me as well, like really, really positive, really, really nice things. So I couldn't believe it. I couldn't believe how many people were excited for me. It was really overwhelming.
I suppose in a way for promoters now, this is just to put like the logistic side of it, they can go, oh, great, we can have maybe Martin win matches now. That's maybe. And you're sitting there going, I've won a couple now, make me win. Yeah, I'll have all the belts. Be all the belts.
Belt collector Martin MacAlistair, here we go.
Did you feel it was like you've been very open about your like weight loss journey and how you're becoming more toned and getting into better shape? Do you feel like it was kind of a vindication for all that time spent and getting yourself into the best shape you possibly can to be ready to be all those weights lifted, to be able to hold that belt and to be the focal point of Iron Girders?
Yeah, I think so. Like it's funny because it was a combination of obviously the losing streak came to an end and that's that big win, but it really is the combination of, you know, 5.5 years, 6 years of my life of, as you mentioned, that when I started wrestling, I was pretty overweight and I managed to lose all that. And then I spent the next couple of years trying to get toned. And I really feel like in the last 6 months, I've kind of hit that next level where I'm now, you know, first of all, I think it was 8 months ago as I took my t-shirt off the first time in a match. And then since then, I just feel like I've been going strength to strength with it. My hair changed colour as well at one point. And yeah, it was a combination of like the professional wrestling kid, but also my personal side of it. So yeah, it's all helped and it's felt like it's all been worth it.
You did mention, I remember seeing a tweet not long after you won about the Martin MacAlistair versus the Streak t-shirts. In one way, it feels like that was a jinx. In a good way, I suppose.
Yes.
you finally made some merch. You got your Martin MacAlistair versus the Streak t-shirts. And then a few months later, you broke the streak and you... and yeah. Now they're kind of a little bit redundant unless you're now chasing a winning streak. And it's now
MacAlistair versus the Streak. I think they're a collector's item is what they are now. You know when like a team goes to the Super Bowl and they put out two sets of t-shirts, like... and the team that, you know, and for both teams to win, the one team doesn't win. I think that's kind of where those t-shirts are now. I haven't put them in the bin just yet, so I'll be I might sell some at the upcoming Iron Girders show, put the money in for the charity box, perhaps.
Not a bad idea. Have you already, big John Cena fan, as you've made everyone very aware of,
yeah.
Is the champ is here with the Iron Girders belt? Is that kind of possibility in the?
I was thinking about it, but I do want to toe on the line of copyright caution.
Maybe. So, like you're saying, we've got a show coming up, so we're going to talk a little bit about that. But before we do, the other thing that we've got to talk about is you're now fairly traveling as well, because you made your Combat League debut on Thurso as well. I know that you and your partner are quite travelers, like to have adventures.
Yeah.
What was it like traveling up Thurso just to maybe do some wrestling instead?
It was fantastic. It was truly a great experience. The Combat League fans were amazing. It was a bit of a bizarro world. Heroes and villains are a bit mixed up, but it was truly amazing, and it really, really inspired me that I just wanted to do this more. Like, it was such a great time. I was traveled up one day and then traveled down the next day. It was fantastic, and it was like, this is what I want to do.
I think we're back. So, for those that may be unaware, we're being hit by tech issues tonight between my internet not working and Martin's Zoom not working. So between the two of us, we might hit an episode. So I think by my reckoning, we recorded about 12 minutes was the first file. So I'm reckoning 2 minutes of that was us not hearing each other. So I reckon we've got 10 minutes in the can already, and I'll figure out a way to figure it out. It'll be fine. It'll all look good, I'm sure, by the time people listen to this. But it'll be fine.
Yeah, the magic of editing.
Yeah, my internet's gone unstable again. So we might be on borrowed time just now. Right, where were we? I can't remember what we were speaking about before we... I think it was going up to Thurso. So that's fine. That's nice.
Yeah.
I've faded it out expertly. And we're now on to the next bit. So I think while we're still here, we should just get the five questions with the champ in. And if I actually thought maybe had time, I would have just done it. But you remember the five questions with the champ, right, on WWE.com. Yeah, I would have made a graphic, but I haven't. I might have. Who knows? We're in a wild west time of, I don't know what's happening now. So this whole thing's knocked my well laid plans. It is just right out the window now. The book is out. That's it. The old Paul Heyman throwing the book out. So yeah. I say five questions, but I think that there's still six left. I've miscounted my own questions, but we'll persevere. So I asked one to take it out, so I had five. I think I've still got five. I've still got six left. Right, we're just going to go for it. So we've got Westy, first of all. There's five questions for the champ. Might as well start with the John Cena one. John Cena is your wrestling hero. Given the option, if you and him became a tag team for one night, who would your ideal opponents be out of anyone in the UK wrestling scene? I think she may have asked before, but times have changed.
No. If anyone in the UK, that's really tough. Because obviously I want to wrestle people I know, but then in the same hand, I'm like, oh, do I want to wrestle people I don't know? I've not wrestled before, so it's a tricky one. Obviously, I'd love to wrestle Casino Brutale again as a tag team. I think they're fantastic. KOE. I'll get a chance for them or Adam on Sunday, but they're one of the best tag teams out there as well. And I did see that Martin Kirby won the tag belt over at Target. And I've always wanted to wrestle him, a wee Martin versus Martin match. So I think that might be my three choices.
There you go. So that's question one. Question two is Chatsunami, who we've mentioned. I'm hoping it made the cut. If it hasn't, mention again. For those that are aware, go check out Martin's chat with Chatsunami and the rest of the things on Satsunami puts together. It's incredible seeing their growth as a podcast.
Yeah.
Just riddled with jealousy as well, seeing how well their numbers are and how much of a... It's because he's really nice, Satsunami, that I think I don't have that in me just to go, I don't have a nice face. I just look like I'm global. Anyway, this is a whole other thing. We're a borrowed time with this internet. Chat Shami asking, there have been a lot of wrestlers who starred in Hollywood movies. If you got the chance, what genre would you want to star in as Martin MacAlistair?
I'd love to be in like a Christmas action movie, like the whole Santa with muscles, Jingle All the Way kind of thing. That's like the dream film for me.
You have played in my wheelhouse here with my Turbo Man in the background. I was thinking maybe throw the Marine in there. Not to go through the Cena path, but throw in a Marine. Like the Miz.
Yeah.
Did a pretty good job.
Technically, I see. I think it was one of them as well.
Yeah.
So good.
I didn't mind it so much, but yeah, it was a bit of a come down from Cena doing the Marine to Ted DiBiase Jr. Which is on Disney Plus, by the way. So if anyone wants to go see the movie, John Cena is a Disney prince, as a technicality.
Oh,
go over
of course he is. He always was.
So that's question two. Got question three. We're going to Instagram. We have Ian Skinner, who hasn't asked the usual bacon question. Although if you do want to tackle it, I will easily ask it. He's just put Orange Crush? Question mark.
No, is the answer to that. I don't want to be with an Orange Crush at any point.
It's best I don't ask anymore.
No, he's been threatened to hit me with one for years, but so far I've avoided it by avoiding him. But I think it's only a matter of time.
We're back on to Instagram. We've got Judas Gray with simply Champ v Champ. So that's the Discovery Wrestling Openweight Champion.
I would absolutely love that. He's definitely someone on my list I'd love to wrestle, and I'm glad that he feels the same way, because I think he would tear it up.
I like Judas, even though I don't think he particularly likes me, but he's I don't put him over enough, apparently. But yes, he is fantastic. It was fantastic seeing him get leathered by a Singapore cane at the weekend as well. That was nice and satisfying for me. Looks like he's going to be facing a vampire soon, which is hilarious for me for calling him Twilighty a few months ago. And that's question four, numbers. And question five is Ellie Armstrong. Technically, she's asked two, but it's a match when and a tag team match when.
I'd love to tag with Ellie Armstrong. I've always loved the idea of, you know, there's always like the hot dogs and handshakes kind of joke when it comes to wrestling. That's what you get paid in. But both of us, we don't eat meat, so it would be hummus and handshakes. No, that would be the name for team.
There we go.
I'd love to wrestle Ellie Armstrong at a show. I think she's fantastic. Another champ versus champ match, too.
Absolutely. Well, I mean, she's a CPW Women's Champion, you know, this day and age.
Yep.
Win any title you want, if you so wish. So maybe one day. Yeah. But no, I like that. I like hummus and handshakes. That's something that you've thought about before. You've had this chat.
I've thought about it a lot.
Absolutely amazing. So yeah, we've got the five questions in. We're relatively safe. So I'm going to try and talk about other things as well. So last time we started talking about your title reign, everything cut out. Then we started talking about Thurzo, everything cut out. So we're going to try and talk about this Saturday. So hope this works. with Iron Girders, they're coming to the Iron Girders gym. Not for an IGPW show, their numbered variety, but for a charity show. So it's for the Isla Joyce. Can't read now because everything's gone so wrong. Isla Joyce Pro Wrestling event to really raise awareness and funds for leukemia as well, which we see Iron Girders doing quite a lot of these kind of charity events in the Glasgow area as well. So for yourself, one, how important for you is it to finally go back to Galgate, to Iron Girders gym as IGPW champion and defending it there for the first time? You defended it in Stevenson against Chamonix. And secondly, when you do these charity events, does it just have a bit of a different atmosphere? Is there a different atmosphere between that and your normal run-of-the-mill show days?
Yeah, I'll start with the second question. So yeah, the charity events, we've done a few of them now, and I think they're fantastic, and I think wrestling in general lends itself to charity very, very well. So, you know, we've done a couple of charity shows. I know ITW have got one coming up as well, and I just think they're fantastic across the board. You know, that's a great way of raising money. The crowd's always up for it, and you get people and that maybe wouldn't come along to a show otherwise. Maybe they don't watch wrestling, but they want to support a charity, and that's really cool. So it was always a fantastic atmosphere. There's always a lot of fun. There's little games to play, played, and extra ways of raising money. So I just think it's really fantastic. So, but yeah, I'm super excited for myself for this Sunday, because this is my first defence at the Gallow Gate. I won it there. It's the place that I've wrestled the most, and it will be really just fantastic to get in front of the fans that have supported me the longest, and hopefully get to impress them with the new Martin MacAlistair.
So you've subtly corrected me. So I will put out there, it's Sunday, April 14th, not Saturday. So if you go there on Saturday, you're gonna be very disappointed. But there's loads of matches announced already. For those that want to get to the show and haven't got a ticket already, they can do. It's at eventbrite.com/irongirders-gym. All ticket information is there. Doors open 1 p.m. and bell time is 2 p.m. as well. There'll be a VIP match in the middle of that, I assume, because there is one announced. So it'll be in between 1 and 2.
Yep.
So there's a big full card here. Do you want to start with your match, or do you want to work our way to... Actually, I'll take that decision away from you. I'll start with your match in case the internet dies.
Okay.
So at least then we've talked about your match. So you are... And then I can try and edit out, so it looks like that we only talked about your match. So you're defending the IGPW Championship, as I said, for the first time in Galgate at Iron Girders Gym. You're defending against one half of KOE, Adam King. So Adam had a little bit of singles experience last year when Marcus was out with, I think it was a broken leg, was it? Or a broken ankle of some description.
Yep.
So he's had a little bit of a go at the singles stuff. You've been doing the singles the whole time and with mixed, very mixed results, but recently it's been good. So what's it like? I don't want to say what your strategy is, because that would be silly, but coming in against Adam King, what's the kind of your thoughts on it?
Well, first of all, I'm really chuffed that it's him that I'm getting to wrestle. You know, he's a fantastic wrestler, and he, like, in his own merit and as part of the tag team, obviously. He's huge. And I have wrestled him before in Easter House under the Girders banner earlier last year, which obviously he won. So it's nice to revisit as many people that have already beaten me as possible. But yeah, he's fantastic, and I'm just really chuffed at him because he's an incredible athlete, incredible person to take on, and I've got my work cut out for me. But you know, I'm not ready to lose again just yet, so let's see what he's got.
That's a fascinating thought. Yeah, because you were, how many losses was it before the big win? Was it
58?
That's a lot of yeah. Ghosts of Christmas Past to revisit.
Yeah,
in your reign. So obviously the initial eventual hope will be 58 wins in a row in Iron Girders, certainly.
That'd be the dream. Every single broken person that's already wrestled me, tick them off.
Exactly. That's what to do. That's this time next year, you'll be 58 and 58, and then yeah, it'll just you'll break it even.
I'll be a normal wrestler by that point.
you'll be able to keep a hold of those Martin MacAlistair versus Streak, because you're just waiting for someone to break it. You know.
But yeah, exactly.
I mean, obviously, the best idea is get a new design and maybe put those towards charity and put that behind you in the new chapter into your new champ status. I apologize for everyone listening to this. I did have a really good idea how I was doing this episode, and just everything has gone out the window for me. So
I'm having fun.
No, it's weird. Like last week I did an episode and I did a couple episodes, and I was sat back and thought, you know what? Not bad at this podcast and stuff. I think I'm on a roll with these episodes recently. And then ever since then, an episode of Ross Hauser, which I had to step out of because I was sick, and then it came back.
Oh, no.
So there's a big cut somewhere in that. And then since then, I've just had really shitter of episodes. And it's my fault. I'm the jinx. My wife calls me the jinx.
Yeah, I was going to say, you've peeved off the podcasting gods and you've messed it up, I'm afraid.
I really have. I'm not allowed to say anything about my son going, oh, he's a great sleeper at the moment, isn't he? And then next night he'll just be up the whole night. I am just rattling. Anyway, right. We're fine. We're still on. We're going to keep going. So rest of the card, we talked about your match, of course, Martin MacAlistair versus Adam King, which I assume will be the main event of this event because you're the champ. The champ goes on. Yes. What will it be like to actually enter second? That'll be quite nice with the belt as well.
I'm really looking forward to that. It'll be fun to enter in front of the home, in front of the home crowd with the belt. So I'm very excited for that.
Now, you've done some pictures of, you did a little bit for the WrestleMania thing. You went Cody Rhodes, you held the belt, the old guitar, respectful way. Have you had a thought how you're doing it with your entrance? You didn't really have much time to think about it when you faced Shaman A, but are you around the waist? Are you over the shoulder? Are you Jeff Jarrett having the bottom strap tucked in?
Ooh, I'd love to wear it around the waist. I think that's just like such a classic look. So we'll see what happens. We'll see what happens on Sunday.
It's good. You're going to try some stuff. Why not?
Yeah. So it's my first time having a belt. We don't know what's going to happen.
You've got to fit in all the looks as you can, just in case, you know, touch wood and everything that you have it for those 58 wins at least. Right. Cool card then. So for anyone still listening to me rambling here, I hope you are. We've got several matches announced. 2, 3, 4. Seven more, so there's 8 matches in total. We'll start with the VIP. Some names I'm very familiar with and seen some clips here and there, so we'll just a couple words on each. We've got the VIP match, which is Hachi. I'm it's not been a good night. Against Gabriel Saul. God, I say that one right. Oh, good, yes. Right, so I'm going to say your last name. That's easier for me. Hashi versus Gabriel. So seen Gabriel a bit and got this very striking look, a very muscly look, and he looks amazing. He looks like $1 million. And I've seen Hashi.
Yeah,
that sounds like I'm going to be really mean to Hashi, but he's also got a very very striking look as well. Is he a bit of a brawler? I'm not quite aware of.
Yeah. Hashi. He's got a bit of a mean streak to him. He's come back to wrestle with a brand new attitude. He took kind of a bit of time off in the last year, but he's come back with a new attitude and he's put the work in. Don't like how he's done it, but it's going to be a great match because the two of them are both on the up and up, I think.
I think we're in a state now where, not to say that you are a target now because you've got the belt, but a lot of people may have, like a Hashi, may have thought, this guy, all these wins, like you're saying, could be seen as a fluke. A guy like Hashi might be thinking, right, if I get a win here, then if I get in with Martin, then I'll be the champ because he's clearly just lucked his way into this situation, you know. So I think it makes all these matches kind of a little bit more deadly, really, for yourself, certainly, but makes the championship picture wide open. At the same time, which...
Yeah, 100%. I've got to watch every one of these matches because who knows who's going to be fighting me next.
Speaking of that, next one I've got on my list here is the former IGPW champion, Eddie Castle, taking on Dylan Thorne, which, talk about it, that's high impact. Former tag team partners in the Manifesto. They've got a little bit of experience with each other. I mean, outside of your own match, of course, this, I would say, from this lineup, that's a match of the night contender right there.
Oh yeah, these two guys, they hate each other. They really do. There's no love lost between them. They're gonna go in, they're gonna batter each other. I think Eddie's fuming after the title match where Dylan Thorne came in during the title match and helped prevent some cheating. So yeah, I think there's no love lost and there's a lot of personal issues there, so it's going to be hard hitting. They're both aggressive people. It's going to be, I'm definitely going to be watching that one because it's going to be nuts.
So yeah, we're there's some interesting matches on this card that we're definitely going to have to get into. Not that I'm skipping any of these particularly, but we've got you're facing Adam. We've got the first ever IGPW champion taking on Adam's brother, Marcus. So Marcus King, like I said, he spent a lot of last year on the injured list. Back now, is that a kind of situation where you kind of look out for Levi because of possibility of Adam being involved in that match, or is that a case where you kind of want to let that play out for your match?
It's a bit of both, you know. Levi is one of my greatest friends. We've been friends for a long time, and he's always someone I've looked up to. But at the same time, he's not a man that accepts help very easily. So we'll see what happens. I want to keep an eye on him, and I want to keep an eye on the two of them, obviously, making sure they don't collaborate to affect Levi in his match. So yeah, all eyes on that one for me. But hopefully, yeah, but I'm hoping Levi accepts my invitation for a bit of help, and I can keep an eye on him for him.
Excellent. And we've got the Dangerous Brothers, Kez Evans, the BT Gun, taking on the team of you guys from the Iron Girder School. We've got James Diaz and Kev IN.
Yep.
So I've had a little bit of back and forth with Kev IN. He was an unfortunate victim to to a rib on the Twitter machine where we announced that he was coming on as a guest, and he messaged me going, what? No. Am I?
Amazing.
So, but I'm excited to see what, I mean, poor guys. I mean, they're coming up against Kez and BT. BT Gunn, of course, famed for his chops and being a hard hitter. Yeah. Kez Evans is coming into this year with a bit of a chip on his shoulder, I think, seeing as he wasn't very, very happy with his performance last year. This could end up just being Evans and Gunn leathering a couple of lads for 5 to 10 minutes.
Yeah, you know, the new kids on the block, James and Kev IN, you want them to, I want to see them do well. You know, I've had a chance of coaching them as part of going into this, but it's a tall mountain to climb. You know, either one of those guys, you know, incredible. We put them both in the team, it's going to be a long night for those lads.
Speaking of long night, possibly, because I don't know what this entails, we've got the Casino Brutale Bingo Brawl. That was all that was announced. I have no idea what this means.
I also have no idea what this means. They've got some wacky thing planned. You know what they're like. They've planned something. They're not telling any of us what it is. So I think everyone in the and the dog's going to be getting ready for a match because nobody knows what that's going to be.
Well, all I saw was the poster, and it was the match graphic for it, and it was a bingo card, as you'd expect. And then I was looking, going, all right, maybe that tells me who's in it. And then Jonathan Gresham was on there. I was like, I feel like that would have been announced beforehand.
Maybe.
So, that's going to be interesting. I mean, Casino Brutale have a reputation for some weird and wild stipulations, especially in Iron Girders, because I will never forget I can't remember the name of the stipulation now. That's really annoying. Deep Hole Danger.
I knew that's what you were going to say.
Which was fantastic. You should bring it back. I mean, I don't know who I'd pick on.
Once a year, someone should be forced to change the name at Girders.
I'm not being honest. It took me a while to say it. So Hashi, I'm sorry that I'm putting you forward for a give me more of a chance to be able to say it in the future.
Oh dear.
That's what happens when I don't come in with a plan, guys. This is you get the verbal diarrhea. Right. We've got the IGPW King of the Fling Open Challenge. Robbie Cardwell defends against, who knows? So you've got a little bit of experience in the King of the Fling. You've had a go of it a couple of times.
Yep.
It's a battle royal. It's essentially just you're getting a Royal Rumble at every card. What's not to like, really? But any tips that you want to pass on?
Oh, absolutely not. No tips from me. I'm not very good at these kind of matches, it turns out. Robbie Cardwell has, I think he's nailed the formula for this. He's athletic. He's got eyes in the back of his head, it seems. He's always able to claw and fight his way back from anything. So he's a hard guy to take down. But obviously, with these kind of open challenges, he doesn't know who's going to be in this match. So I think he's asking for a lot. You know, the Iron Girders champion lost his belt in an open challenge. So you do have to be careful when you're doing this stuff. But yeah, we'll see how he gets on.
Yeah, you set the precedent here. If an open challenge could easily spark the title being going away. I mean, I'm sure Moxie Malone's probably going to try and get her 100%. Back in there. There's going to be a lot of, I mean, when I get the results for these shows, I look at the list of names like, Jesus, this, when you say open challenge, they don't like go, only a couple of these can come in. It's generally like a good 10 to 12 folk that turn
up. If you've got your shoes and you've got your tights with you, then you can get in there.
Got to look out for the masked assassin. I don't trust that man. I don't know if it's a man, that woman, that assassin. That
assassin.
And the final match that we speak about, we've rattled through this because, again, fear. We've got the ACME, the title that I can never rattle off quickly. The ACME Comic-Con Interpromotional Championship. And a triple threat. We've got Angel Hayes defending against Casey and making her Iron Girders debut. We've got Brody Adler coming up, who you would have met recently up in Thurso.
Yeah, I've also wrestled her once before as well. And at Grassroots, she's well-deserving of being on this show, and I'm really excited to see what she gets up to, because she's been another one that's been putting the work in to such an amazing degree. Obviously going up against two of the best in Scotland as well. As you know, how going to be two? Is that two of the best in the world, probably, in Angel Hayes and Casey? So, you know, you've got, as a combustible match that with all three of them, who knows? I don't, like, it's going to be an amazing one as well. I'll be watching that, because all three of them deserve that belt. So, I mean, I can't wait to see it.
So, that's the full lineup. Like I said, I thought it was going to take us a good 20 minutes to go through, but as time is ticking, we're just like, no, I'm just going to rock through the line. So, yeah, for those that want to know more, they can go on to Iron Girders social media. They will have all the information available to get tickets and for everything else as well. But this is raising money for Isla Joy and Leukemia Awareness as also. So, a great cause, a great thing to do. For those that are maybe uneducated, for maybe have more of a wrestling mindset, Roman Reigns had leukemia. You know, it can hit literally anyone. It doesn't matter whether you're big and strong and Samoan, or if you're Isla Joy, who's a young girl, I think, if I remember right.
Yeah, only 2 years old.
Oh, God. That's...
If you can't make the show, there is also a GoFundMe online. I think Gerda's been posting the link for that. I think a few of us have been as well, so... but if you're looking for that, you can message me directly and I'll send it on. But yeah, that link's been floating around as well. So there's a GoFundMe which you can donate to directly if you can't make the show.
Fantastic. So yeah, it's a great cause. Doors open 1 p.m, bell time 2 p.m. There'll be a VIP match in the middle. Tickets are still available. Find the social media. You won't regret it, because I hear so many good things about Iron Girders shows that, unfortunately, I'm up in this end of the country, but it's one of those promotions that I hear so many good things about. I'm glad. I need to get to the Iron Girders gym. It's the only time you'll get me in a gym would be to watch some wrestling, I think. So we've rattled that card. We've kind of talked about your match as well. So let's look forward a little bit, and then we can wrap up, and I can figure out how I'm editing this together. So you've one defense in, hopefully two by the end of the weekend as well. We've already mentioned the possibility, joked about the possibility of going back through your 58 losses and picking off everyone that you can to vindicate that title victory. But do you have any thoughts and things you want to do with that belt, whether it's take it like the AMC Comic-Con Interpromotional Championship, take it to other places, defend it in certain promotions? Do you have a plan for this belt?
I don't have a plan as such, but there's just a lot of ideas. Like you mentioned, with, you know, everyone on the Iron Girders card is going to be looking at me now. Everyone's going to want a shot at this belt, and I want to defend it. I want to defend it against everyone and anyone, whether that's in Iron Girders, whether that's outside Iron Girders. If that door gets open for me, I'll defend it in any promotion. I want to take it with me places. I want it to be the best belt it can be. I want everyone to be after it, because that only makes me better. You know, steel sharpens steel, and I want to prove that I'm worth holding it. So, yeah, line them up and knock them down. I think open the door and I'll be there, because this means the world to me that I have this belt, and I want to show everybody. I want to show it off everywhere I can.
Fantastic. So of those 58 losses, is there anyone in particular that you want to maybe rekindle sooner rather than later?
There's a lot. Obviously, there's a lot of people that have easier access to than others. So a lot of people are still on the Girder shows. But then there's people on my very first loss ever was to DCT, who's much harder to get a hold of now. He's not even in the country. So I think I just have to prioritize as I come along. Probably, you know, looking just at the Angers gym roster itself, you know, BT Gunn, Casey, Levi, Kez Evans, like I've wrestled all them and I've lost all them, and I'd love to get a shot at, you know, getting a bit of retribution against all the coaches that I Angers would be a nice clean sweep.
A bad way to do it.
Yeah.
Speaking of that, then, of course, we do know that Wolfgang does do some feedback and that. We see him watching the shows on social media, put up photos and that. Have you had a chance to speak to the big cheese himself about your title win? Has he had any advice for you?
Yeah, I got. He phoned me on the night that I won, and he just, you know, he's very, very proud of me, very congratulatory. But yeah, basically, very similar to what John Cena said in that. He mentioned it on the Pat McAfee show the other week about he said it to Cody about it gets heavy. And he kind of said something similar. Just, you know, that's a lot of eyes on you now. And he knows I work hard, but, you know, there's even more eyes on me now. So work hard and do what I can. And that's what I intend to do.
Wasn't it mad when the news came out that, well, maybe not mad, but the Gallus were the guys that were helping The Rock?
Unbelievable.
That was, I couldn't, as soon as I read it, I was like, hang on, let's just reread this.
It just goes to show you the quality of, you know, Scottish wrestling. I think of all the people that got picked, it was Gallus. You know, it shows you how well regarded we all are in Scotland, and how great the Scottish wrestling scene must be for that to be the people they pick. You know, out of everyone in the world they could have picked, it's three guys from Scotland. I think that's just so amazing.
Absolutely. So I think we will wrap up while we can, and we can maybe do a post record like seance and hope that everything works. But for those are, thank you very much for the patience and taking the time to speak to me. I know that you've got other podcasting endeavors with, like, through Chat Tsunami and the Podcasting Collective. You've got your D&D one, am I right in thinking that?
Yeah, so I've been part of a Dungeons & Dragons podcast called Stop, Drop and Roll Initiative. We're trying to get that kind of released, and it's been a lot of fun. It's been a lot of challenges, so I'm used to a lot of these technical mishaps, but it's been great, and I'd love for people to give that a listen. We've got two episodes, I think, out just now, and yeah, a lot of fun. I love playing Dungeons & Dragons, and it was great to get a wee bit of audio for it. So please check it out if you get a chance.
Go check it out. I'll try and remember to put links in there as well. But great. So for those that haven't got a ticket, go get a ticket to Isla Joy's Leukemia Awareness Show. That's happening this Sunday, April 14th. Hopefully I've been able to put this out and I haven't tore my hair out, what's left of it. And I'm sitting there on Friday just going, no, it's not happening. But it will. I'll make it happen. But this has been an absolute, like I say, other than the chaos, it's been great to speak to you, Martin, because it's been great to see the outpouring of love and support that you've received, winning that title and breaking the streak. And I'm glad that we were able to carve out what was supposed to be half an hour of time. Here we are an hour later. we were able to carve out a bit of time and speak about it. And I hope next time we speak, like I say, that streak is the opposite now. It's a winning streak, and you're holding that belt for as long as you plan to, as long as you want to. But for those that want to find out more, mentioned Stop, Drop and Roll Initiative, but where else can people find out more about Martin MacAlistair?
I am all over social media. My main one is Instagram, at Martin MacAlistair. But you can also find me across TikTok and Twitter, and Facebook as well. But mainly stick to Instagram because that's mainly the only place I know how to post properly. The other three just kind of follow trends of what I'm doing on Instagram. And yeah, and come see me wrestle on a show because I'll hopefully be on a show near you soon.
Perfect. Well, thank you very much.
Thank you. It's been an absolute pleasure.